As in the previous lecture, we have turned with the stanzas and we have turned with the difficult words and exercise A. On page number 15, I have told you the answers of exercise A on page number 15. Now, take your pencils in your hands and write the answers on the page number 15, exercise B. The first question is, during what season of the year do most bathing accidents occur? Most of the bathing accidents occur in summer season. Number 2, which one of the flags signals lifeguards on duty? As you know, we have read in the unit that flag 1 signals that lifeguard is on the duty and no swimming flag was the and no swimming flag symbol was flag number 3. So in the blanks you will write flag 1 and flag 3. Number 3, name a plaything that might be dangerous to bring into water. So what toy can be dangerous to bring into the water? So you can write the answer, toy guns can be the dangerous things to bring into the water. Why it could be dangerous? Number 4, because pellet guns cause eyes injury to the guns, to the kids. So this answer can be the good reason that why the toy guns are dangerous to bring into the water. So they are dangerous because pellet guns cause eyes injuries to the kids. Number 5, what are the 4 letters of the water safety code? You have to write these words in the bold, SAFE, because this is a safety code. It is not a word here. It is the 4 letters mentioned different abbreviations. Exercise C. Imagine you are at the seaside. Your friend is on a toy boat in the water. A big wind is blowing the boat out of the sea. Think, what can you do to help? I have told you this answer would be from your own self, because you have to imagine the situation and you can write, I will call the lifeguard to help my friend. Number 2, I will take the boat into the water to help my friend. And you can write many answers by your own. In the exercise A of page number 16, you can see they have given you a specific address and they have instructed you to write the address in a proper order. In the first, they have told you to write the person's name. So you can see the person name is Mr. Simon D'Souza. So it will come in the first line. In the second line, house and street. So you have to write the house and street. The house and street will be 37 Seafield Terrace. Number 3, town and area. The town and area is Waterloo. Number 4 is city, London. And number 5 is country, England. So first you will write Mr. Simon D'Souza, 37 Seafield Terrace, Waterloo, London, England. So in this way you can write the address in a proper way. Now exercise 17 is page number 17, exercise A, comprehension. You have to choose the word from the given list to make it an appropriate word, but you have to choose the word which suits the action. For example, explain problem. Number 2, watch television. Curl hair. Number 4, close door. 5, ting B. Listen music. Number 7, skate ice. Number 8, knit jumper. Number 9, prepare meal. Number 10, peel orange. So in this way you have to write in front of them the appropriate word which suits the actions. Number exercise B, name each group. You have to name the each group. They have given you some words which constitutively makes a group. You can see number one, chair, sofa, stool, armchair, couch. So these all things came under the category of furniture. Number two, beetle, ant, green fly, wasp, spider. So these all things came under the category of insects. Number three, pajamas, dressing gown, night dress, slippers, night shirt. So these all things came under the category of clothes. Number four, Jane, Sarah, Olivia, Emily, Geeta. So they all come under the category of girls. Number five, mumps, chicken pox, flu, measles, cough. So they all come under the category of diseases. Number six, reading, baking, knitting, dancing, singing. So they all come under the category of verbs. Number seven, porridge, cereal, eggs, toast, beef. So they all come under the category of food. Number eight, CNN, BBC, ETV, QTV, Nick. So they all come under the category of channels. Exercise C, page number 17. Word structure. You have to write the syllables. When we pronounce a word, then word is divided into different syllables, many syllables. For example, when we say giant, you can hear that when we pronounce giant, so it can be pronounced in one breath. So it has only one syllable. Number two, causeway. You can hear that causeway is pronounced into two breaths. So cause and way, it can be divided into two syllables. Number three, and trim. So you can hear and trim. So there are two syllables. Number four, gigantic. Gigantic. There are three syllables. B. Here, two syllables. Flower. There are two syllables. Number seven, plant. So here is only one syllable. Number eight, beautiful. So here are three syllables. Number nine, seed. So here is only one syllable. Okay, I have written two syllables. It is wrong. There is only one syllable. Number 10, honey circle. Here are two syllables. Number 11, garden. Here are two syllables. Number 12, lawnmower. Lawnmower. So here are three syllables. Now exercise D, page number 17. Sentence structure. Underline the word in each sentence that does not belong. You have to underline the unnecessary word, which is extra word in the sentence, which make the sentence inappropriate. For example, number one, please don't do want that again. So if I remove want from this sentence, so the sentence will be, please don't do that again. So it looks appropriate when I remove want from it. So want is unnecessary word. Same in the second, she pushed, fed the child by accident. She pushed the child by accident. So fed will be underlined. I am almost finished the start word. So am and start are unnecessary words. I almost finished the task. Number four, the pupils are gone at work. The pupils are at work. So gone is unnecessary word. Number fifth, I would like another an apple, please. I would like another apple, please. And is unnecessary word. Number six, I am very happy that I won the prize. If I remove no, so it will be proper sentence. Number seven, did you do the jobs for me? Did you do the jobs for me? So it will be wrong. So did you do the jobs for me? The waves crashed over the rock. You cannot say crushed. So crushed will be underlined. Number nine, the clock stopped yesterday, tomorrow. The stopped is second form of verb. So Yesterday is suitable here, not tomorrow. The clock stopped yesterday. I like summer because it is so warm. Of course, summer is warm, not cold. Exercise E, page number 17. Teaser time. Unscramble the letters to find the correct word. Number 1. Not a sister, but a brother. What do you do in the library? Reading. You use it when shopping. Trolley. Part of your foot. Ankle. Place to hide from the rain. Shelter. Now, this is your homework task. You have to make sentences of the following words. Silently. Camera. Slapped. Delight. Bathing. Thank you. Allah Hafiz.